A few remarks to make here. Prepared.
We much prefer unprepared.
I'd like to thank everybody for coming. I think it's great everybody's here. Obviously, thanks to Mary and Gary for their Texas-sized hospitality. Thanks to Marty and Helen for all the great work they've done. And thanks to the bridal party. And thanks to the ring bearer. Where did he go? Where did he go? Lukey, come on. But typically, in a situation like this, it's customary to recognize the person who's traveled the farthest. And I think in this case, as I look around the room, it's probably me. I'd like to thank me for coming. And welcome. Yes, I'm going to stand up. Now, I've noticed since I've been here that Texas is a little more spread out than New Jersey. A little bit. Well, I did the math, and you can fit over 30 New Jerseys inside of Texas.
No.
But why would you? That's messing with Texas. I'd like to say a few things about this guy. As you know, he's doing some pretty cutting-edge stuff out of that crazy lab out in California. There's really nothing new about that. When he was in high school, he took a course in computer networking, and his grade average for the year for that course was 104. And the kids in the class, only 104. And the kids in the class, what they said about John was, he's from the future. So he's still from the future. But at the same time, tradition is important to John. When he was in like maybe second or third grade, it got to be the night before back to school. And we were all getting ready and got to be bedtime, and he put on a pair of superhero, he was like second, third grade. He put on a pair of superhero pajamas and sat next to me on the couch. And he said, the night before school, I always like to wear my best pair of superhero pajamas. And I'm thinking to myself, okay. Then he says, it's a small tradition. So tradition is important to the man from the future.
Yeah.
Do you have some super?
What are you wearing tonight?
You asking me or him?
Him.
Underoos? I think it's Batman.
Batman.
Underoos?
But anyway, don't heckle me. It's hard for me to put into words how proud I am of John. And who he is and how he lives his life and all that. But a very smart woman who got to know John once said to me, she said, you know, if you, meaning me, if you ever feel bad about yourself, or you're not happy with your life, or how things are going, all you gotta do is point to John and say, that one's mine. Mm-hmm. That came from me. That's all you gotta do.